52b at the very bottom of the page. Ve lo haya chatzer b'Yerushalayim. So the Mishnah tells us that it wasn't any courtyard in Yerushalayim that wasn't have enough light. It was 50 cubit high of light that blinked in a way that brought a tremendous amount of light. Tana, Isha hayta boreret chitim l'or shel bel hashovar. We are at page 53. So they said that a woman will be able to sort wheat by the light of the big light of the drawing of the water. So here Tosfot asked a question, beautiful question. He said there is an issue of a misuse, Isur Achila. He brought a Yerushalmi that said that you cannot use it. So he said, "Haita yechola livror merov ura," which means, in a way, the woman has the potential to do it. Basically, she did it at night, and then she went to the drawing of the water celebration. Chasidim anshem anshe hayu meragdim. The people, the pious people, the righteous people, used to dance around this big celebration of the Simchat Beit HaShoava, the drawing of the water. Tanu Rabbanan Yishmael Omrim, Asher Alutenu Shelo Bishai Ziknutenu. There are those who said, praise upon our childhood, that didn't make our old age embarrassment, let's face it. There are some people who reach the age of 90, 80, 70, 60, 50, and they embarrass of what they did as say kids, right? Or they did in their childhood and the growing up. It's all kind of thing that was very inappropriate. And they said, praiseworthy to Hashem that we overcome those temptations in our childhood. Elu chasidim v'anshei maaseh, which means chasid is people who are pious and people of good deed, that they follow the path of Hashem in their childhood, so they are thankful for that. V'yesh umrim ashrei ziknuten shechapara ha'yaluteinu. These people of balei tshuva, that they said that we made a lot of mistakes when we are kids, when we are teenagers, when we grew up. Now at the old age, we atoned, we did teshuva for all the mistakes we made in our young age. Elu balei tshuva, elu ve'elu umrim, ashrei mi shelo chata, umi shechata yashuv v'imcholo. Praiseworthy is the one who didn't sin, but one who sinned. So he made a teshuva and Hashem will forgive him. This is a famous Gemara we study, if you remember, at the very end of Tractate Yoma, we study about a Baal Tshuva Amiti, a real penitent. And we said, for example, if someone has temptation to chocolate, he cannot overcome that temptation. Someone has temptation to alcohol, to drugs, to women. Everyone has his own temptation to certain desire, certain inappropriate desire. So he said, the beauty of that is that when you are in the age that you have those temptations and you'll be able to overcome, that's the beauty. Because when you reach the old age, that no longer, you don't have those desires, those temptations that you used to have at your youth. So that's what the Gemara and Yuma said. But the Noam Elimelech, Rabbi Elimelech of Lizhensk, he said in this parasha, Parasha Tazria, the very beginning, and he explains that one of the key points that the person needs to help himself to pave his way to Hashem, to connect it to God properly, is to do a personal regression to the time of his childhood and try to repair those mistakes by at least making the proper confession before God and promise that those mistakes he will not repeat. Tanya, amru alav alel azakim kshaya semech besimchat bet ha-shoeva. Amar, ken, im ani kan, akol kan, im ani kan, mi kan. Hillel was the president of the Jewish community, the head person, very humble person. And when he celebrated the drawing of the water, the Beit HaShoeva, he said, if I'm here, then everything is here. But if I'm not here, who will be here? So the rabbis ask a question, what's going on? This is a man of humbleness, and that's what he said. So it is a disputation between Rashi and Tosfot. Rashi said that he meant to say God, not him. Look at the word of Rashi. Four lines from the top. Doresh haya larabim. He was a public orator. Shelo yachetu b'shmo shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Sheim ani kan akol kan. Meaning, as long as God here, everything is here. Kol zman shani chafetz b'bayit hazeh u'shchinati shehu haya bo yekvudo kayam. As long as me, meaning the Almighty God, is dwelling in this house, and the divine providence is there, so everyone will come here. Ve'im tachteu v'aselek shchinadim yavo lecha. If you committed a sin and I withdraw, God said, my divine providence, then who's going to come here? So meaning Hillel, in that sense, did not speak about himself. He just used an anthropomorphic language to speak about Hashem. Tosfot said, Piresh Bakuntres, he brought to there, but he said, Aval Birushalmi, etc. Israel. So according to the Tosfot, it's if me, meaning the nation of Israel, that I speak on their behalf as the president of the community, I'm here in order to praise Hashem, so everything is here. Because Hashem, in a way, wanted to have them praise Him. We said every day, Va'ata Kadosh, Yoshev Tehilot Israel, that in a sense, God dwell upon we as the people who praised Him. It's a famous phrase of him. They said, Ve'ahavta Lerecha Kamucha, love thy fellow as thyself. So some people misconstrue it and think that that's the end of the story. But the truth is, there is a condition at the end of the Pasuk. They said, Ani Hashem Elokechem. It's a condition. You should love your fellow with a condition that there is Lord your God. You have to remember that there is God there. Otherwise, it's nothing. Hu haya omer ke lemakom she'ani ohev sham ragalayim molichot oti. Meaning, a person goes the place that his wish to. So in other words, the legs is just a servant of you. And whatever you wish, you go. So he said, Im atah tavo el beti. In a way, he talked about Hashem. He says, it's like God said to us, if you come to my house, which is the Beit HaMikdash, ani avo el beitcha. In exchange, measure for measure, I'll come to your home and bless you. אם אתה לא תבוא אל ביתי, if you're not going to come to my temple, אני לא אבוא אל ביתך, I'm not going to come to you. שנאמר, in the book of Shmod, Exodus 20, בכל המקום אשר אזכיר את שמי, אבוא אליך ורחתי ראו, whatever you mention my name, I'll come and bless you. אף הוא רג מגולד אחד שצף על בני המים, that's famous משנה, interacted in פרקי אבות, interacted too, is so a skull, one skull that was floating on the water. So he said, he recognized that that skull was the murderer face, someone who murdered other people. And Hillel recognized the skull floating on the water that is the skull of the murderer, which means it was a paying back act of other criminals. And they put him to the water. So he meant that it's measure for measure. The same way as he hurt other people and kill other people, it was a time of paying back. אמר לי, אל דעתף תדפוך, וכל מיטפייך יטופון. Which means, because you drown others, they drown you. And those that drown you will be drowned. Which means that it's all this world functioning in the measure of measure for measure. So Rashi said, that's a statement of fact, that everything in our world happened as a measure for measure. No bad deed come unpunished, right? That's what
No good deed is unpunished.
That's right. Omar Rabbi Yochanan, that's a continuation of what Hillel said, Ragloi de bar inish inun arvin ba, le'atar nemidbay et aman yovil yatei, which means, in a way, the legs are basically the collateral, or the one who basically leads the person. A person's going to a place that he's supposed to depart from this world to that location. So the idea is, we said on the high holidays that everything is inscribed at the beginning of the year. So we believe also that inscribed in heaven, where, when, how each of us going to pass away. So in other words, if it's a decree in heaven that the person need to die in Panama or in Israel or whatever it is, that's what's going to happen. Hashem will lead his legs to go there and finish his life there. And every circumstance was planning for Hashem to make things happen in that direction. They want to follow up with the story. Hanu trei kushai. It was two kushiyat, meaning people like from Kush, from places like Ethiopia, etc. That in general you should know that Kush in Judaism, it sounds of beauty. The Torah tells us in Parshat Baalotcha, that is the act against Ayin Hara, that is the act of beauty when they mention that. The Havu Kaime Kameh Shlomo, that they came before King Solomon. So the names Eli Chorev Vachiyah Bnei Shisha Sofrim, that's the name. The Shlomo Avu Yom Achad Chazel Malach HaMavid Ava Karatzil Amar Lo Amai Atziv. One day King Solomon saw the angel of death sad. He asked him, why are you sad? Omar Le Dekabal Minayah Nitar Dekushay Diyad Ve'acha, because they asked me for heaven to take a life of these people and I can't kill them, I can't get rid of them. So when Solomon heard that, he wants to save them. Masrinu lasirim shadrinu lemachoz adelud. Again, it's a deep material, so we just try to go literally. So they said that King Solomon understand many languages, including the languages of the demons, ghosts and things like that. So he brought it before them, and they sent him to a city called Luz. It's a city of truth, it's a city that Malach HaMavet cannot enter there. That is Gemara in Sota, page 46. And they said that Malach HaMavet could not enter, angel of death could not enter that domain. Kimatu lemechoz alul shchivu. But when they're about to enter that gate of the city, boom, they passed. Lemachaz, chayze lemach HaMavet nekalev kavadach. The next day, King Solomon saw the angel of death, that he is happy. Amar le amad bedichat, why you are so happy? Amar le batar devar minay taman shderin tu. So I exactly get rid of them in the place that they supposed to die. Meaning it was set a plan that King Solomon did not realize. The angel of death wants him to do that. And as a result, he sent them over there. And when he sent them over there, they die the place that they are designated to die. Miyad patach Shlomo ve'amar. Then immediately King Solomon opened and he said, "Ragloi devarini shinun arvin be'ilatun mitpayet aman tov movin." Exactly what we said earlier, that everything comes in account: the location, the time, the way that the person die with respect or die with a disgrace. In other words, no human can escape from the omnipresence, from God, and from God's judgment. We cannot escape from him, period. Tanya. They said about him that when he was celebrated the drawing of the water, he used to take 8 flaming torches, which if you know some Jewish weddings, you have those guys that playing. So it's a very beautiful, it's like playing with those. And they said, just give you the idea, the Maharal explained that is musagim ruchaniim, that it's a very high level of understanding those numbers. He said that 7 is the teva, 8 is above the teva, above the nature. Anyway, and when he bowed down, So he did something, he prostrated himself, and he will insert the two thumbs into the ground. ושוכב ונושק את הרצפה וזוקף. ואין כל בריאה יכולה לעשות כן, וזוהי קידה. So he basically kisses the floor of the Beit HaMikdash, and no one else can do that, excluding him, Rabbi Shimon Gamliel. And they said that's basically the kida, that's the bow down in his level, which means no one else can do that. He used such a little part of his body to make this happen, just the toes. Levi achve kida hakamei de Rabbi veitla. Levi tried to do it, and he became a disabled. So Rashi said, בביתו של נשיא ומכבדים אותו לסמכו והדואג תמיד בצרד ישראל ובכל יון המעבדרים יום המדמלכת בפוריון המעטי. So basically Rabbi wants to help the people, and it wasn't a happy day. He's always concerned about it, and he tried to make him happy. So he tried to do this way, and unfortunately he hurt himself and he became disabled, he was limping since. והגר מלא. So they tell me that that's the reason they became like that. ואמר רבי אלעזר, עולם על הדריח אדם דברים כלפי מעלה, שראה אדם גדול דרך פניו דברים כלפי לה, והתלה, ומנו לוי. He said a person should not say anything against Hashem. If he did it, so he get punished. An example of the punishment is Levi. So the Gemara in Tani 25 said that it was a time that there was a great famine and they need the water. And he said, Almighty God, you know, you are in heaven, and how you allow this to happen, etc. Which means it's not because he prostrated himself he became disabled. The Gemara say Haveha Garmalei, which means he entered himself to the place of angels, dangers, and this and that, the both make him disabled. Which means the cause of that, it was because he speaks about against Hashem in a way, and the time of punishment happened later when he bowed down. Anyway. Aruch Lanel said other reason. Anyway, Levi Amtel Kamed Rabbi Betamne Sarkinei. He used to play with eight knives. Shmuel Kamei Shavur Malka Betamne Mazgir Chamra. Shmuel was used to play before the King Shavur, the King of Persia, with eight glass cups that they filled of water. And none of the water of the field of wine. I'm sorry, none the wine spilled. Abaye kamei de rabba bitman abaye. He used to play in eight eggs. Vamre lebarbabe. Those who said four. So in other words, this is special talents. Tanya amar Rabbi Shua ben Chananya. Rabbi Shua ben Chananya was among the Leviim, the Mishorim. So they say kshenu smichim b'simchat Shavua, when we celebrated drawing the water, lo ainu shana ve'einu, we didn't sleep. כיצד שעה ראשונה תמיד של שחר, משם לפיית, משם לקורבן מוסף, משם לתפילת מוספים, משם לבית המדרש, משם לאכלה ושתייה, משם לפיית המלחם, משם לקרבה תמיד בין ארבעים, which means they have a busy schedule, full day. And Rabbi Akiva Iger quotes the Tashbetz. He says that basically they went to daven mincha after the afternoon daily offering. And the question is, since the daily offering in the afternoon is the last one of the all the other offering, so Maharam Ipono explained it that was the reason, because they follow the subsequent order the same as the Shacharit. מכאן ולחתמנו לשמחת ושואבה. So הנה איבה אמר רבי יוחנן שבוע שלו אישן שלושה ימים מלכין אותו. If someone make a commitment that he will not sleep 3 days, they give him מלכות וישן לאלתר, and he have the obligation to sleep right away because he cannot fulfill this order. That's גמור in שבועות 25. אלא אחי כמר אותם נותם שנה דאבו מלאם דה אקרת ודה דה דה. We didn't sleep, like we just nap on the shoulder of each other, go on the army bus, Gilbert will tell you, right Gilbert? Mm-hmm. And you see the soldiers sleeping while they're standing, or sleeping on the bus, one hold the shoulder of the others, right?
Yeah.
The Mishnah said that Leviim al 15 ma'alot, it was 15 steps between the men's section and women's section, and is equivalent of the 15 Psalms, Shira Ma'alot of Asens, in the book of Psalms. Omar Chizda Lumid Rabbonon, the sages in Amoim have a different expertise, and it was people who were expert in Agadeta. So that was fellow the Kava Kama said that Agadeta Kama, that it was a very familiar, you know, by heart, a lot of rabbinic writings and hermeneutics, classical hermeneutics of rabbinic writings. Omar Le, Rav Chisda said, Shemi Alach, Hanei 15 Ma'alot, Kina Gidmi Amaram David, why King David composed these 15, equivalent to whom, 15 Psalms. Omar Le, that what a sage said to him, Achei Amar Rabbi Yochanan, Beshaa Shekara, David Shittin, when King David used the Shittin, and you remember we talk about it, that either he disputed the Mande Omar, that hold that Hashem created it, or it was blocked and it was opened by King David. In other words, during the beginning of the creation, we learn, if you remember, about the Shittin, which was a special drain that was open for all the libation of wine and water. So, and it was under the altar that those libation come. Kafat Toma, all the water of Abyss come up. ובעל המשטף העלמה, they want to overwhelm the world with water. אומר דוד 15 מעלות והורידן, King David said 15 psalms, and he was able to take it out. אחרי 15 מעלות, יורדות מבעל, it's not ascend and descend. אומר לי, אוהל ועד קרטן מלטח, he came out, since you mentioned that, I'm going to say it, בשעה שקרא דוד שיטין, when King David created those holes under the altar, קו התאומה, הוא בעל המשטף העלמה, אמר דוד מיקד אלה, ישם למכתב לי. So it was a special formula that carried the name of Hashem, and that formula was able to stop the process. So he asked if anyone knew if you're allowed to, especially for this purpose, to write the name of Hashem. 53b, Achaspa v'nishdei betom ha-manach. This is really a frightening material. We are forbidden to write the name of Hashem in vain. Here, what he tried to do is, he tried to take the earthware and to put, Rashi said, a full name of the God, of Holy of Holies of God. And that act will stop the flooding of the water. So, the big question is, what you're doing? In one hand, you're avoiding crisis, right? On the other hand, you caused the name of Hashem to be erased. So the problem here, King David did not want to rule by himself. He wants to use his Rebbe, his teacher, Achitofel, to rule that. Because, again, the big question is, you see a crisis. You see the water coming out from the terrible situation. Are you allowed, listen carefully, to take this piece of earthware, to put the full name of Hashem, to put it in the water? The name will be erased, but it will stop the flooding of the water. Is that okay or not? That's the question King David had. So the big question is, why Achitofel did not answer, which is another subject, it's above the scope of this discussion. But Leka de Kamler Midei, so no one answered. Omar David said, Kol di adale meimar velomer yichanek begrono. We are in a state of crisis. So no one give me the answer, and have an answer, should be dying chalky. נסע הכי טוב לך וחומר בעצמו. הכי טוב ורספנס, מה לעשות שלום בן איש לשלום התורה, שמי שנכתב בקדושה עם החל המים, לעשות שלום לכל העולם כולו, הלכת כמה וכמה. So the Torah tells us in the book of Bamidbar, we all know that when there is a suspicion, the husband suspected his wife to be disloyal, remember? So what do you need to do? He needs to go sota, he needs to go before the Kohen. The Kohen needs to do something that sounds unbelievable. He needs to take the parchment and put the name of Hashem in full, put it in the water, and let her drink it. While what happened, meanwhile, the name of Hashem he raised, which is a violation of the Ten Commandments. Yet, in a way, Hashem said, it's okay even to go against my own commandment, to erase my name in the water, in order to bestow peace between husband and wife. It's worth it. So he said, if that's something that we allow to do, לעשות שלום לכל העולם כולו על אחת כמה וכמה, to make a peace in the entire world, how much so that it's permissible? אומר לי שרי, he said to David, go ahead and do it. כתוב שמחס פה ושרי לתהומה, He did it. He wrote the name of Hashem on the earthworm and threw it in the abyss. Venachit etom ashitzar fegarmide. That's something above us, that the ground moved in 16,000 cubit. Yichad ze nachitu ve'amar kirmal limilet finirita me'alma. So in a simple way, for sure, there is much more Kabbalah. Just go by the simple way, the Ben Yada, the Maharal, have a lot of explanation. We go with just the literal interpretation. So in other words, he did it, and he said it's good for the world, that it's a watering, that bringing a lot of produce to the world, and he basically caused the water to return 15,000 cubits high, and it's a response, or it's an equivalent to that. He composed the 15 psalms, 15 essence of that praise to Hashem. So Aruch Laner and others said that you should remember we have this the prayer for the water on the Sukkot, and we have the libation of water, and it's all connected to the 15 prayers, 15 psalms that King David made. Anyway, running out of time. That they, we derive from that the root of the world is 1,000 cubic. V'achaz in the karaputa v'nafke maya. They say that you see that it's less than 1,000 cubits. Marsha have a long malach. If you have time, read Marsha, beautiful. Amarav mesharsha u'mesulma defrat. Let's go from the Prat River. V'amdu kohanim b'shar elyon shiyored. Now we learn the Mishnah. The two priests who stand in the high gates. And they, what they do a blast of shofar, takut, veriyo, vetaku. Tekiya, teruah, tekiya. So they said, by Rabbi Yirmiya, lemala, asir it neachil kamisha, v'achasra odin man, nachil asra v'akaya chamisha. How it means that these 15 steps, and they stood at the 10th one, or that they ascend the 10, and they stood on the fifth stair from the bottom, teiko. They still left unanswered. And meaning that they turn the back and they release, which again, it's a way that they express the disrespectful to. Anyway, that's what Rabbi Yudah said. Eini, is that true? V'amar Rabbi Zera kol omer shma shma, kilo amar modim modim, which will not accept two entities of Hashem, is only one. Ela achi amre, hema mishtachavim kedma, v'anu leka mishtachavim v'anu leka miyachalot, which means they are doing in the false way of serving Hashem, and we are doing the other way around, to show the most respectful to Hashem. Mishnah. The Mishnah tells us, en pochatim 21 tkiot b'migidash, v'nosifim 48, you see the picture, that they have the way that they blessed and they use when they did it not less than 21 and not more than 48 blessed. So, which means every single day they have 21 tekiot and a certain day it was 48. So they said, the Rashi explained that it was in certain order, it called it kol pashut. Was tekiya, and then it was teruah, the staccato, and then another tekiya. So it's called tarat, what we do in the high holidays. So bechol yom 21 tkiot b'mikdash, every day it was 21. Shalosh lepitichat sharim, there are three that it wasn't a mitzvah, but it's only a sign to remind people that the work that week, that they should come and do the job, v'teisha letamid shel shachar, nine for the morning service, v'teisha letamid shel arbaim, and nine for the daily afternoon service, u'bamusafin, and those days that they have additional service, which is Shabbat, Rosh Chodesh, holidays, so u'musafin moteisha, they add another nine, u'bechol erev Shabbat, u'musafin shalosh, v'abtil tam melacha, tell people that they have to stop to do work, that they do in the time of the people in the field, which is the mincha, in the afternoon, v'shalosh, v'abtil mekodesh lechol, another three, there to separate between the holy and the secular, which means that that's already chiyuv ski life, someone did some type of work. Erev Shabbat shebetoch chag, the eve of Shabbat, doing the festival of Sukkot, hayu shem 48, it was 48, shalosh lepetichat shearim, three for open the gate of the courtyard, the same as every day. Shalosh l'shar yom, three, l'shar nikanod, the high gate. ושלוש לשטר הדרטון, that's the gate that connected to the ground of the women's section, ושלוש למילומיים, and three for the place that they returned to the gate of the water, ושלוש לגבי המזבח, and three when they put the ערבה in the sides of the altar. תשע לתמיד לשחר, and nine for the morning service, ותשע לתמיד לשחר בארבעים, and nine for the afternoon daily service, ותשע למוספים, nine for the מוסף, שלוש להבדיל לעם מלאכה, three to remind people stop the walk, ושלוש להבדיל מכל שלחול. So it's all together 48, מתניתין, זה לא כרב יהודה. Mishnah is not going to Rabbi Yehuda. The Tanya, Rabbi Yehuda, Omer Papochet, the minimum of blessing the Mikdash, lo yifchot mishav shunat, make it less than 7, v'amosif, lo yosif al 16, one do add more, not more than 16. So Gemara elaborate and said, what's the real disputation? Like, if like Rabbi Yehuda savar, tkiah trua, tkiah achat, v'rabbanan savrei, tkiah lechud, trua lechud. So the first one, which is Rabbi Yehuda said, it's one combination of mitzvah which contain tarat, tkiah, trua, tkiah. The sages said, no, each one of them is separate. Ma itamad Rabbi Yehuda? What's the reason of Rabbi Yehuda? Amar kra utkatem trua. So the pasuk said, you should bless trua. So I explained my book, Birua Kruma Barashi al Hashas. The Rashi said to you, utkatem trua. Alma trua in utkiah. Kloma medikra utkua tkiah shma min achadai. So again, I elaborate here a lot. But so basically the question is, what's the real difference between the tekiya and tevua? I urge you to read it. I don't have the time. וכתיב תרועה יתקעו, על מה תרועה תקיעה אחתי ורבנן, לפשוטה לפניו אחראו, again, it's the rushing, כלומר, it's the explanation here. What's really the difference between the two? רבי יהודה לפניו אחרא מנעלה, how do you know that it's have a regular tekiya before and after, and afkalei shenit, because the Torah said, תקעתם תרועה, second time, רבנן, my time, ההוא דכתיב, they said, ובכל לקרא, תתקעו ולא תריעו, when you gather, assemble the people, you should make the tekiya, and not teruah, which means the simple one, ויסא גלדך, if you tell me tekiya, teruah, אחתי, if you tell me it's one, אמר רחמנא פלגא, the mitzvah עביד פלגא לא עביד, the Torah tells us to do half of mitzvah and half not, רב יהודה, ההוא לסימן הבעל מהו דעתה. It's just when Moshe wants to talk to them and not a commandment, so it's enough in just tekiya. ברבנן, סימן ההוא, רחמנא שב למצווה, the Torah considered this a mitzvah to together in that sign and not the other. כמאן הזלחה, למה רב קנה, whom that point of רב קנה goes, אין בין תקיעה לתרועה ולא כלום. There's no difference between תקיעה לתרועה, and only one breath. כמאן כרב יהודה, because according to רב יהודה, the three blessed is one mitzvah, and you should not separate between them. So the Gemara said, אי רב יהודה, or without אי רב יהודה, פשיטה. It's clear that what רב קנה said, follow רב יהודה. Why was it necessary for the Gemara to raise the matter at all? So we are now page 54. Ma'au detema afilu kirabonon. You may think that what Rav Kahana said, even by the sages, and it's correct that the person can separate between tekiya and terua a short time, like a little add more than the regular taking a breath. And they said, ulapuga de Rabbi Yochanan. And to go out with what Rabbi Yochanan said, to exclude the opinion of Rabbi Yochanan. The Amar, he said in Tractate Rosh Hashanah, page 34, Shama tesh tkiot b'tesh shor. If someone heard nine blasts of the shofar in Rosh Hashanah in nine different hours, b'tesh shor b'yom yatsa, he fulfilled his obligation, separate between each voice. So, in Ikar Adin, a person needs to hear Rosh Hashanah three times three, which is nine. Kamash Melan, so then the Gemara teaches that Rav Kahana forbids to stop between Tekiah and Teruah even a short time. So in other words, you do in other words, it doesn't separate between them. And the truth is, even nowadays, when you conducted the one of the reasons we need someone who's erudite, Matkiah, not only the Tokeah, not only Baal Tokeah, the one who blessed it, but even the person who instructed him, he needs to be familiar with all the process, how to do it. But the one who blows the shofar needs basically to do it in one shot, not stop, take a breath between Tekiah and Teruah, or Teruah and Tekiah. So the Gemara asks, Ve'eima hachei nami, So the May, you may said that it is indeed so that Rav Kana holds that the follow the sages, and he merely comes to exclude the view of Rabbi Yochanan. Ulapiku de Rabbi Yochanan. No, imken mai velo klum. So what does that mean? At all in Rav Kana's statement, there is no pause between the Tekiah and Teruah at all. So it means, according to that you cannot stop between them even a short time, and that's basically follow Rabbi Yehuda that holds that it's one mitzvah. First practical halacha is the Parashat HaTamid. It's different nuschot between Sephard and Ashkenaz, between the Tfilat Mincha. So here we have the Braita that Rabbi Yishob ben Hananya described the way that we have it in Chag HaSukkot. And we said, כשהיינו שמחים שמחת בית הישיבה, לא ראינו שינה בינינו, when we celebrated the drawing of the water, we didn't sleep, slept, and כיצד שר לשמר כליום תמיד שחד, this is all procedure. So it follows what we study in Brachot 26, that תפילות כנגד תמידית, that we have now a lip service, which is a prayer, in equivalent to the offering that we have in בית המקדש. So, meaning the Tashbet said that even the time when the Beit HaMikdash was in existence, they still have those prayers. Which means the whole idea of praying three times a day, Shacharit, Mincha, and Arvit, it's not as a result of the destruction of the temple and annulment of the offering, but it's only as a Hakbalah, it's an equivalent to the time of the work in the Beit HaMikdash. There is a book called Petach Enayim, here in the Gemara that explained Shacharit, the morning is the morning offering. Mincha is in the Ben Arbaim. Marib is Hekter Chalavim, the bring the fat and the limb, the Emurim. So the Marsha said, if you look carefully at his statement, the beginning they did the offering, the daily offering, then they make Shacharit, but the offering of the afternoon happened after Mincha. So it means that those prayers, the Marsha said, is only part of the walk in Beit HaMikdash. And he said, nowadays, when we are now basically in the era that Beit HaMikdash destructed, and we believe it will be rebuilt, but meanwhile, what we said the Korbanot, there are those who said the daily offering before Mincha. So in the morning, the Remai and Orach Haim, 48 said that we did Parashat HaTamid. If you look at the Korbanot in the morning, we said it daily. And also, according to the Rama, before Mincha, he said, Norach Haim, Reish Lamedalet, 234, Ki Minahag Yafe. It's a good idea to say. So the daily Parsha, it's in a commemoration of the daily offering that they used to bring early in the morning, everywhere. Now, so what do we derive from that? That there are those who do the lip service, meaning the prayer, as a substitute for the bulls. Now, how about Ashrei? We have this prayer Ashrei in the Mincha. So, Remami Pano, in chapter 14, he said that following this Gemara, it's better to make first Mincha and then to do the Korbanot. But he said, Yisrael bnei Nevi'im lo nagu ken. So the Magen Avraham in Reish Lamed Dalet said, so that's the idea of saying Ashrei Ashrei Vaitecha and then the Korbanot. But he followed the Zohar that said that Ashrei is like davening Mincha. So it means when you do the Hagdama, you do the Korbanot. So again, the Mishnah Berurah said that there are those who do it before. And Rabbi Akiva Iger and Gilyonas Shaz, as we said, brought the Tashbet. So it means that there is a Girsa that said that the first deed the daily afternoon offering, and then they do Mincha. Now, another halacha is Shulchan Aruch HaRachaim 61. It is prohibited to recite Shema twice, whether one repeating the word Shema itself, or whether it's repeating the entire first verse. If he must repeat the verse because he did not have the requisite intent, when he recites the first time, he should not repeat immediately. It's should pause a bit before repeating. In other words, to be careful not to have an impression for someone who's not educated, like you're praying to two separate entities. Tkiot b'Mikdash, that's the Rambam, Ilchot, Kli HaMikdash. Each weekday, 21 trumpet blasts were sounded in the temple. 3 for the opening of the gates in the morning, 9 for the daily offering and 9 for the daily afternoon offering. On a day on which additional offerings were sacrificed, 9 additional blasts were sounded in honor of the additional offering. Each, if multiply additional offering, were offered marking different occasions. For example, when Shabbat and the new moon coincide, they sufficed with the same 9 blasts, as thus the Mishnah said, contrary to the opinion that we have later in the Gemara. The last halacha of today is the Tkiot b'Shabbat u'v'Moadim. It's Rambam Ilchot Klei HaMikdash, chapter 7. On Friday, 6 additional blasts were sounded. 3 to stop people from the labor, and 3 to deliver and demonstrate between the sacred and the profane. And on the festival of Sukkot, these 3 additional blasts were sounded for the opening of the lower gate, 3 for the opening of the upper gate, 3 for the filling the water, and 3 more when pouring the water libation on the altar, which we said that's the call, the Nisuch HaMayim, Shibaneh Beit HaMikdash, Bimera Bimeinu, Amen.
Amen.
Shuloim, Malachai, Shuloim, Malachai.